All right, welcome back. So in our last video, I showed you how to upgrade the Keystone 3 Pro to the Bitcoin-only firmware. And I'll leave a link in the show notes below to that video. But in today's video, what I want to go through is setting up a wallet on the Keystone and then how to incorporate that into Sparrow Wallet so that we can actually view and see our transactions. The beauty of this is both Sparrow and Keystone are completely separate entities, and they both open source. And this is a highest form of security. So you have security with functionality, and it's a great combination. So let me walk you through this. I've done a video on Sparrow Wallet, how to verify the download and how to set it up. And I'll link to that video in the show notes below. So just some prerequisites. We're going to need obviously our Keystone 3 Pro, and I have an SD card and an SD card reader. I also have a power brick in case I need to power up my device. The first thing you're going to want to do is verify your device. So when you receive it in the mail, you want to make sure you verify the device, and I'll show you how to do that. This device I've already set up, but I'll show you the process. It's much the same. So what you want to do is just hit the three dots at the top right, and then go into device settings, and then system settings, and hit verify device. And then what you want to do on the website of Keystone, just come over to device verification. And if you click into that, you'll see the device verification page, and just click the verify device, and that'll generate a dynamic QR code. And then on your Keystone, you're going to scan that code and just let it sit tight, let it scan. And that should give us the verification we're looking for. So now I'm just going to enter this code into my website. 8MCVV. And then just click verify. And it's authentic. So this is a good practice to do. Definitely do it. Don't skip this process. Okay, so now that our device is verified, and as I said, I've already set up a wallet on my device, but I'm going to set up a new wallet, which would be the same process as setting up a new wallet on an uninitialized device. So I'm just going to go into the three dots at the top, go to device settings, and I'm going to go into wallet settings, and then add wallet. And I'm just going to enter my PIN. This is where you would be. Just going to enter into this. So we're going to create a new wallet. You'll see at the top it's three of three. Keystone, you actually have three wallets within your cold storage device. So you have three cold storage wallets separate in your device, which is actually a great feature. So let's create a new wallet, and I'll walk you through this. All right, so we are going to create a new wallet. Hit create wallet. I'm going to enter my PIN off camera. Okay, and now we're going to give it a name. You can call it anything you want. Okay, so once you've given it a name, just hit the yellow arrow, and we're going to set up our seed phrase. We won't do the Shamir backup. Just for this example, I'm going to do the regular 24 seed words, okay? So this is where you want to make sure that you're alone, you're not going to be distracted, and what you're going to do now is they're going to give you the 24 words. You're going to write them down, and obviously just number them 1 through to 24. Legibly write them down on pen and paper, no digital copy, no photographs of this. Pen and paper, legibly 1 to 24, and I'll see you in a bit. So, guys, once you've written down your words, it's going to ask you to confirm your seed, and you're going to do that by selecting the words in the correct order that they were given to you. So, I'll check in with you. Just re-enter your words in the correct order that they gave them to you in. Okay, so that will generate. Make sure that you keep your device on. So once you've entered the words in the correct sequence, you'll get this screen and it's going to generate, and make sure you keep the device on. So once your seed is in order and you have verified it, you're going to come to this screen, which is our home base screen. You got your receive and your scan. So in the next, now the wallet is set up, okay? So in the next step, we're going to take this wallet and we're going to import it into our Sparrow. So we can actually do transactions via the Sparrow wallet. All right, so what we want to do, top right, the three dots, just hit that. And we want to connect software wallet. Select that, and you'll see Sparrow is in the middle. There's also Blue Wallet and Nunchuck, but today we're just doing Sparrow. So we're going to hit Sparrow, and that'll generate a dynamic QR code, which we'll scan with Sparrow. So I'm going to head on over to the desktop, and on Sparrow, I'm going to go File and Import Wallet. Okay. Now you'll see a couple of options. There's a lot. Just if you scroll down, keep scrolling, and you'll come to Keystone. And there's a multi-sig. We don't want to do the multi-sig. You just want to do the regular one. So the first one, and we're going to hit scan. So we scan that. And then what we'll do is place this in front of the scanner. And that picks it up. And you get to see a little bit of the set. But anyway, so that's in there now. And now we're just going to hit import. So now it's in. We're just going to hit import. But just before we do, you'll see there's a script type. It's a native SegWit. If you hit that, you can see the pull down. You can see other options, Taproot, which is the newer one, and Legacy. Just keep everything as is. Native SegWit is the most efficient in terms of cost as well. So keep it as is and then just hit import. It's going to ask you to give it a name. You can give it any custom name as well. I'm just going to keep it as I had it before and create wallet. So hit create wallet. And do you want to add a password for this? I'm not going to, but you can if you want. Say no password. And that loads up our interface on Sparrow. So let me dive into the desktop and I'll walk you through this. Okay, so back in the desktop, you see your Sparrow layout. I've gone through this in depth in the other video, which I'll link in the show notes below, which was basically how to set up your Sparrow wallet. But this one's a little different because we have imported this in from our Keystone. So just very quickly, you have your transactions, your send, I'll click into them, your send address, your receive, okay, your addresses, and you have. What's interesting about the addresses is you have your receive addresses, then also the change addresses. So the receive addresses are what you would give out to receive the Bitcoin, and then the change addresses is what the wallet uses when it needs to have a place to store the change. We won't get into that too much now. And then you have your UTXOs, which will be listed here as soon as you start seeing transactions coming in. And again, UTXOs, the best way to understand those is essentially like in a physical wallet where you have paper notes. Essentially, your UTXOs are much the same. So, if you have 100, a 50, and a 20, you would have three different UTXOs for each. So, that's just something there. And then we'll go into settings. I'll just give a quick rundown on the settings. It's a single signature, okay, that we've set up with our Keystone, and it's native SegWit is the script type. This it will say, okay, it says watch only, because in Sparrow. This is a watch only. So you can receive funds into your wallet, but you can't send them out. You will need to sign with the Keystone to sign and send out. Okay, and I'm going to get into that in a little bit. The label is just internal to the wallet. And now the master fingerprint. Okay, so just again, the master fingerprint is what we get when we take the private key, which is the seed, and we generate a public key off of that. So that's how Bitcoin works. It works in key pairs or pairs of keys. And the derivation is essentially the derivation path is like a map, a root tree of folders. I won't get too much into that in this video, And then at the bottom, we have our XPub and our ZPub. And basically, the XPub is a representation of the public key at this derivation path. Okay, so without getting too much into the weeds on that one, let's send some funds in, which we can do no problem. And then we're going to send some funds out, which we can do, but we're going to have to sign with our Keystone. We're going to send some funds into this account, making a note of the address. And I always check the last few letters and digits at the end there. Sparrow encourages you to label things. So I'm just going to label this where it's coming from. So this is coming in from another wallet that I have. And I will send funds in. And then we'll go through the process of once it's received and confirmed. And then once it is confirmed, we'll send it out again. Okay, and funds have just come in. So I've just sent the funds in. It's roughly 42,000 sats. So that's going to come in. And we can just check in our transaction. It should be coming in here. It's unconfirmed. And we'll wait for that to confirm. And then, like I said, we'll send it back out. But the circle is empty at the moment, and it needs six confirmations for it to be completely confirmed. But as soon as we get one confirmation, one little slice of pie, when it gets grayed out, then we can work with it. So we'll just wait for it to confirm, and then I'll come back to you. So we have a few confirmations. We've got three confirmations. Pretty solid with three confirmations. With six confirmations, it's mathematically impossible to reverse the transaction. So we're good to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to send these funds out now, and I'll send them back to my wallet, and I'll show you the process and how we sign with the Keystone 3. Okay, so I've pasted my Bitcoin address in. And I am going to just label this. I'm sending this out to, I'm just going to make a note of that. Always double check the last few numbers and letters at the end of your Bitcoin address. Confirm it's the right address. And then what we can do for the UTXOs, this is where I'm going to get into the UTXOs a little bit. If we click on the UTXO tab, we see that there's one UTXO. I want to select that and send the full UTXO back out. Okay. And UTXO is unspent transaction output. Okay. So we're going to send the full amount. So 40,000, almost 41,000 sats, which is $28 US. Okay. For the fee, it's always a good idea to jump over to mempool.space. Okay. And there you can see how congested the network is. From low priority to high priority, and then depending on how fast you want this transaction to confirm or how much you're willing to spend on it, that will determine what fee you set. But Sparrow does have this nifty tool where you can actually slide it up or down. So you can make it slightly less, but you're going to wait longer, or you can slide it up, you're going to pay more, but it's going to be faster. So we're just going to keep it just a little bit as is. And we're going to send this out. I'm going to jump to the overview camera, and I'll show you in the next clip. All right. So guys, everything is set. Bitcoin address is in. I hope you can see the screen, but we're going to broadcast this transaction out. Okay. And we're going to say create transaction. Sparrow has this little diagram at the top, which I like. It shows the transaction, shows what's going on in the background. You have your transaction, and then you have your fee. So we need to sign this. So we're going to, basically what we're doing is we are within Sparrow. We're going to use our Keystone to sign the transaction. Okay. And what we're going to do is going to say show QR code. Okay. And on the Keystone, we are going to hit scan and point that at the QR code, and then it tells you what the transaction is. Okay, so hopefully this is focused. It says the amount, it says the fee, and then it also says from where it's going and to where it's going. Okay, so you want to make sure that that all lines up and is accurate. And then if you're happy with that, we can just slide this over and there she goes. I'm just going to enter my password and signing Now, okay. So now what we need to do is now we need to tell Sparrow to scan this QR code on the Keystone. Okay. So we're going to say scan QR code, and we're going to place this now in front to scan. It picks it up straight away and it says Keystore One ready to broadcast. So we're going to hit the blue button and there she goes. So that is how you use the Keystone to sign your transactions from Sparrow. And it tells you that the funds are leaving. And those funds will now be received in the Bitcoin wallet I'm sending them to. And that is essentially how we use the Keystone to do a single sig signature in Sparrow Wallet.
All right, so that was a quick tutorial on how to use the Keystone and Sparrow together in an air-gapped form. So air-gapped is the QR code, and that's how the information is transferred. The hardware wallet never touches the internet, and that's key. One thing you want to do as well is when you are sending funds to wallets, always maybe just send a smaller amount as a test before. Just to confirm that everything is good and you have the right address, etc. And then once you confirm, then you can send a bigger amount. So that's just one thing to think about as well. So I hope you guys learned something. If you did, give us a like and subscribe and ring the bell because there's lots of content coming. And we'll see you guys in the next one.